all about, man. Today's video is about stickers and graphics and vinyl applying, whether if you're applying it to the wheels that you've seen in my previous upload there, kind of giving you guys an idea on what I did to apply the Yamaha lettering vinyl stickers on the 17-inch wheels of the WR250X. Last night, I started kind of messing around with my AFX FX41 DS helmet, and I said, you know what, I absolutely love this helmet, but it is very white, and there's not much contrast to it. But then I started thinking, you know what can I do to kind of fill it up a bit, you know, fill up those gaps. You know, this one does come, it is the dual sport helmet, so it does come with a peak. And then I started thinking, you know, maybe should I do some graphics and stuff like that. So basically what I did is I ordered up the Yamaha, through the Yamaha website. We sell a product from Factory FX, which is a big, you have multiple different sizes, right? So I went with the 36 inch total length, 36 inch by 7 inch almost, just the Yamaha logo, the wording, and then the tuning fork. And you know, I kind of started placing it on the helmet here. So as you can see, this is what I've done as of last night. Basically, I've applied the vinyl graphics onto this helmet, and it ties it up nice. Like, it kind of fills up a bit, right? It takes away. I wanted to go with something a little bit more abstract, right? So I said, you know, I don't want it all just super clean and super nice. I mean, whether lettering is cut off and whatnot like that, again, it's just a gap filler. It was just a filler. And so that was the goal. So I think in regards to what I wanted to do, it kind of worked out really nicely. Once I get the peak on top of here, as you can see, there's still like a big bald spot on the top, right? So I said, you know what, I'm going to take this rest of this graphic here, and I'm going to apply it up onto the top and kind of slowly work it in. So that's what this video is you know, applying even your regular decals, your regular stickers, onto a surface that has a lot of contours, that has a lot of you know, changing of shape. And just basically taking your time and working it slowly, same as what you do with the wheels. I'm gonna do it with a helmet. So yeah, hopefully it works out. If it doesn't, you know what, no big deal. Like, again, you know, you don't have to be 100% accurate. It doesn't have to be perfection, right? You know, again, when you're up close to it, yeah, okay, you're gonna see some imperfections of it, but you know what, for the most part, people don't see that, and when you're riding and stuff like that, it doesn't really matter. So you know what, don't set your objective, your goal to be, you know, oh, it's got to be the best of the best, and I'm not gonna accept anything less than that. If it works out, great. If it doesn't, you know what, peel it off and just move on. I mean, it's only a couple of bucks, and it gives you something to do, and it kind of personalizes, you know, your helmet yourself. So, you know, 10 people do it, not all 10 are gonna be the exact same feature of it, so that's what's cool. Make it unique, make it yours, and just take your time, and that's what we're gonna do. So let me get myself set up with a headset here and a camera, so you're gonna see exactly what I see, and let's see if it works. Okay, so now that we've got this kind of set up, and I've got both a camera on my head here so we can kind of get a look, and then a side view, hopefully we'll work it out. What we're going to do is, like I said, we're going to apply this decal here now onto the top portion of the helmet. I'm not 100% confident that it's going to work really well, but again, I was also the same feeling for these, and that worked off okay. So generally, you know, on this graphic here, I find the actual protective coating on the top is a little bit too rough, so it's very tricky to work with. So I think the best thing to do probably is just to have as the least amount of material to work with at one time. So it's definitely going to be a little bit tricky. I think the best thing to do is simply just cut off as much as one can, and then it will just make it a little bit easier, because you have so many contours and angles and different bends and shapes to a, especially to a helmet, right? Because now you're working with both, you know, angles this way and that way, and then anything that's in between. So it's definitely going to be a challenge. This decal, I find the protective coating is very, very hard to work with. I find it's actually a little bit too tacky already. So even trying to peel it off, it's very tricky to do. So ultimately, the first thing you want to kind of do is make sure that you're applying it or you're going to find the specific spot that you want to apply it. I'm looking at this fastener here, which is for the top peak. So I think for the most part, this is going to be my center line. I don't want this too far forward. I do have a vent that comes here. Just try to get the most flat portion of the helmet, which would be this. So just kind of, yeah, let's kind of go like that and see what happens. Basically, it's all about just taking your time and just being extremely patient in regards to setting any of the decals on, regardless of what it is you're doing, whether if it's a flat surface or a curved surface. We're lucky enough that this one here, I am able to use a lot of the components of the helmet. So I think that's going to be it. I'll need to apply these pieces here, you know, are not attached to the rest of this, so we're kind of work with that. It is going to be very tricky to get everything to work together. Like I said, the hardest part is this protective piece. Again, patience. It's all about, see how this graphic is just so bloody tough. If I was able to remove this protective coating first, I would have. Okay, so we've got this laid out here. What we're going to do is carefully lift the rest of this back up. And just, slowly get it applied down. You always want to make sure you got a good clean surface, a well prepared surface. Doesn't work, improvise. So we can do that. When you're cutting, make sure not to apply too much pressure so you don't cut your helmet. Could work. So anyways, that gives the kind of the idea of what to do. I'm gonna add some heat. So there you go. So for the most part, it's pretty much done. You can just kind of work at it a little bit slowly here and there and just kind of, you know, finish it off. There's a few parts here where you can see the edge is kind of cut off. So you know what, slowly trim it up. Clean it up, there you go, so there the edge is clean. Again, if you're gonna look at it through a microscope, yeah, you're gonna see there's some imperfections, but for the most part, you're not gonna see that kind of stuff. And it still turns out really nice. Looks absolutely great. And then once you finish off putting the components back on, that is also going to hide all the little bits and pieces anyways. Okay, this one shouldn't be too hard. So there you have it. For the most part, I finished up pretty much everything. I just got to kind of do a little bit of tidying up on some of the little strangly bits. But as I said, it's fairly simple as long as you take your time, work all the angles, and go and get it in there. Get it in. You don't have to go for absolute 100% perfection. It just kind of gives you an idea what the total outcome is going to be like. For the moose part, it's really, really nice. So, as you've seen on the video for the wheels, you know, certain things you had to do some trimming and some cutting. That was also the same thing for this here. As you can see, this is a moving piece, and I had to put the decal around it. So basically just cut it. Again, once you get all that stuff done and you're looking at the actual finished product, a lot of those imperfections kind of disappear. And the overall outcome is actually pretty cool. So there you go. So we took a full 100% white helmet here, and added some spice to it. So once I get this on, and I'll just kind of finish it up, just you know, just do a few more little heats and presses, and just kind of work it out and trim off a couple of extra little bits that are not needed. But overall, as you can see, that only took a couple of minutes to actually physically do. And yeah, so here, let's get this up like that. So there you have it, right? So pretty simple, not too bad. Just take your time, and you've taken an absolutely 100% plain helmet and added some style to it. So hopefully that gives you guys a little bit of inspiration. And I know that a couple of you reached out and asked me how the decals are actually placed. So there you have it. And hopefully with this little edit and some magic of the video, you'll get a good idea. And yeah, you continue on. And if you guys have any questions, let me know. I'll answer everything that I have. And until next time, guys, be good. Have fun. All right. Woohoo! All right, check it out. What do you think? My dad did the top tuning fork.
That looks all right.
Not bad, eh? Yeah.